Let's bring in former Trump campaign foreign policy advisor and author of The Choice, Waleed Fares. Waleed, right man and the right time, sir. Thank you so much for coming. These leaked documents, they undermine the credibility of the Biden administration. They undermine the confidence that maybe our allies had had in our ability to protect the free world.
And not just that, Eric. I mean, your introduction is amazing. This is a summary of a class of international relations, but it's true. It is dramatic. And your example now of what happened with the documents is probably the biggest hit against our credibility in terms of national security. And this whole train has changed direction, as you just said. Since 2009, when President Obama went to Egypt and addressed not just Cairo University, the Muslim Brotherhood, organization at Cairo University, and signaled to all these radical forces around the world, everywhere, that America is not legitimate enough. That's the problem. And after that, we saw what happened with the Iran deal. I mean, who would trust the United States when we trust a regime like this one? But what's happening now, Eric, despite everything and under this administration, has bypassed what happened in, during the years of the Obama administration. To have these documents being circulated, I mean, any investigator will immediately react and say, either we are penetrated, I mean, who could do this, or we are making mistakes of this magnitude that would put a lot of questions by our allies, our ex-allies, you just mentioned a few of them, about our credibility. So it's going to be very difficult, even after this administration, to restore credibility.
You know, give us a sense of how dangerous, at least this latest bungle flub by the Biden administration is.
We are already in a critical time. Saudi and, as you mentioned, the other Arab states are traveling towards China, Russia, etc. They're not going with them, but they're going away from us. And then the fact that you mentioned that they're using the Chinese currency is already dramatic. Now Egypt. Egypt has been relying on us for the last 30 years since the Camp David agreement. There is also criticism against Israel that this administration is, I mean, who else? And now this is going to be damaging to our relationship across the Atlantic with France.
Well, you know, the Saudis, They beg us every year to sell us our highest technology arms, and we do because they're a friend in the Middle East, and we have a oil relationship with them, and now they're willing to trade oil for Chinese yuan, undermining our dollar. There's a pattern, right? I mean, these countries can't continue to do things like this because I think they're doing it because they know Biden has no bullets in his chamber.
He has no bullets, but he fired the wrong bullets on the wrong people. Remember that the Saudis have done everything the Biden administration told them to do, but then when they urged the administration, what are you doing with Iran? Iran is our enemy. And we continued, you know, working with the Iranians, sending billions of dollars. Iranians bought ballistic missiles, fired them on Saudi Arabia. At the end of the day, even the Saudis, our best friends for many decades, said, we don't want to be with you. Let us be who we are. And that's why I'm not surprised that the Saudis will go even further, or farther, if I may say, in their distancing themselves from us.
Well, it appears to me, you know these things way better than I do, it appears to me that the Chinese are making inroads into so many countries.
Oh, yeah.
Into all countries, almost.
Yes, especially in the Middle East. Remember, not just they put the Saudis and the Iranians together, that's an earthquake by itself, it has a lot of ramifications. But 1 week after, Chinese, Russian, Iranian vessels, marine navies, were maneuvering behind our back in the Oman, the Gulf of Oman. I mean, strategically, we will be isolated in the Gulf if we continue with this policy. It's very dangerous what's happening.
How important was Bagram Air Force Base?
That base should have been at least the only piece that we should have kept in Afghanistan with some special forces. It is important, number one, because it's the largest. We are not anymore present in Central Asia, which prompted all these forces to go after us everywhere. But this is the only base that we could use to deter China because we're not far from China. You know, China is on the other side of Afghanistan. And let me summarize it by saying the way we left Afghanistan signaled to all our foes that we are weak, that we will abandon our allies. Everybody understood it.
You know, Trump famously dropped bombs on the Syrian air base with Russian soldiers on the air base. with the Chinese President Xi Jinping at Mar-a-Lago. Remember that? They would finish on their entrees. They were waiting for dessert, and Trump comes back and says, "Oh, by the way, I just dropped, did 50 Tomahawks into the Syrian air base in the Russian in the world." But it wasn't that it was such a majorly successful bombing raid. It's that it kept everyone on their off. They didn't know what he was capable of
exactly.
doing.
Exactly.
With Biden, they're pretty sure they're going to get a free pass.
They have a reading of everything. And this was the turns under Trump. I mean, you like it or you don't like it, but that was the turns in Syria, in Iraq, going after these Iranian militias, getting to the top leader, Soleimani.
Soleimani,
and then deploying in the Gulf in a way that the Iranians, the Russians, and the Chinese did not do anything during those 4 years.
Well, really good having you. Appreciate your time. And I think there's more, because, folks, there's 51 pages that were leaked so far. We don't know if that's the end of it. There could
we
be
don't.
More. Final thought?
Probably not.
Probably not.
Probably not.
You can't imagine what's coming next.
That's the tip of the iceberg.
Tip of the iceberg. Waleed Faris, thank you so much.
Thank you.